Welcome to Civil Engineering Edge. Today, we're diving deep into one of the most crucial aspects of structural engineering. Foundations? What are they? Why are they important? And what are the different types? Stay with us as we explore their applications in various soil and load conditions. Let's get started. Section 1. What is a foundation? Animation of a building transferring loads to the ground. A foundation is the lowest part of a structure designed to safely transfer the load from the building to the soil. It ensures stability, prevents settlement, and resists environmental forces like earthquakes and floods. Choosing the right foundation depends on factors such as soil conditions, load type, and environmental factors. Section 2. Foundations. Categorization of foundations into shallow and deep foundations. Foundations are broadly classified into two main types, shallow foundations and deep foundations. Let's examine each in detail. Shallow foundations. What is a shallow foundation? A shallow foundation is a type of foundation that transfers building loads to the ground at a relatively shallow depth compared to the overall height of the structure. These foundations are generally placed at a depth of less than 3 meters from the surface. Shallow foundations are used when the topsoil has sufficient bearing capacity to support the structure's load without excessive settlement. They are cost-effective, easy to construct, and widely applied in small to medium-sized buildings. Shallow foundations distribute the structural load over a wider area to prevent soil failure. They are best suited for stable and compact soil conditions where the load-bearing capacity is adequate. The design of a shallow foundation depends on factors such as soil type, water table levels, and the weight of the structure. To ensure stability, proper soil testing and reinforcement techniques are necessary before construction. Applications of shallow foundations: residential houses, low-rise commercial buildings, and small industrial structures. Bridges and boundary walls where deep excavation is not necessary. Structures built on cohesive and compacted soil with moderate bearing capacity. Dry or low water table areas where the risk of soil erosion is minimal. Cross sections of different shallow foundations. 1. Spread footing, isolated footing. Description. A spread footing, also known as an isolated footing, is a common type of shallow foundation used to support individual columns. It consists of a square, rectangular, or circular concrete base that spreads the load of the column evenly over a larger area, ensuring the soil can bear the pressure. This type of foundation is effective in soils with moderate bearing capacity and is designed to prevent excessive settlement. The size and thickness of the footing depend on the column load and soil conditions. To reinforce stability, reinforcement bars are used in the concrete slab. Spread footings are cost-effective, easy to construct, and widely used in small to medium-sized buildings. Applications: spread footings are typically used in low-rise buildings where soil conditions are relatively stable and capable of supporting the structure without deep excavation. These footings are also suitable for residential houses, commercial buildings, and industrial sheds with light to moderate loads. However, in areas with high water tables or poor soil conditions, isolated footings may not be suitable due to the risk of uneven settlement or soil instability. 2. Combined footing. Description. A combined footing is used when two or more columns are placed close to each other and their individual spread footings would overlap. It helps distribute loads more effectively when space constraints exist, such as when a column is located near a property boundary. These footings can be rectangular or trapezoidal in shape, depending on the relative loads from the columns. The design ensures that the centroid of the applied loads coincides with the centroid of the footing to maintain stability. Combined footings are reinforced with steel bars to prevent structural failure and to enhance load-bearing capacity. Applications: combined footings are typically used when individual isolated footings are not feasible due to the limited space available. They are also preferred when the column loads are uneven, requiring a more balanced load distribution. This type of foundation is common in urban construction, commercial buildings, and boundary-adjacent structures where optimal land usage is crucial. 3. Strip footing wall footing. Description. A strip footing, also known as a wall footing, is a continuous foundation that supports load-bearing walls. It consists of a strip of concrete laid beneath the entire length of the wall to distribute the load evenly along the length of the structure. Strip footings are reinforced to prevent cracking and can be designed as simple concrete pads or reinforced concrete beams, depending on the load-bearing requirements. They are suitable for moderate soil conditions where uniform load distribution is needed. Applications: strip footings are used in residential buildings, boundary walls, and light commercial structures where the walls play a significant role in supporting the building's weight. These foundations are particularly effective in soils with moderate bearing capacity and areas with consistent soil conditions to minimize differential settlement. 4. Raft or mat foundation. Description: a raft or mat foundation is a large, continuous concrete slab that supports the entire building or a significant portion of it. This type of foundation spreads the load over a wide area, reducing pressure on the soil and preventing differential settlement. Raft foundations are particularly useful in weak or compressible soils where isolated footings may not provide adequate support. These foundations are heavily reinforced to withstand bending moments and shear forces, ensuring structural integrity. Applications: raft foundations are commonly used in high-rise buildings, industrial plants, and structures built on expansive soils with low bearing capacity. They are also used in earthquake-prone areas where uniform load distribution is critical to maintaining stability. Deep foundations. B. What is a deep foundation? A deep foundation is a type of foundation that transfers building loads to deeper soil layers or bedrock when the surface soil lacks sufficient bearing capacity. These foundations extend several meters below the ground surface, providing enhanced stability for large and heavy structures. Deep foundations are essential when the soil near the surface is weak, compressible, or subject to significant seasonal variations that can cause settlement or instability. Deep foundations are commonly used in high-rise buildings, bridges, and infrastructure projects where a strong support system is required to withstand dynamic loads. Unlike shallow foundations, deep foundations require specialized equipment and construction techniques, making them more expensive and time-consuming to install. However, their ability to anchor structures to firm soil or rock layers makes them indispensable in challenging geotechnical conditions. Applications of deep foundations: skyscrapers, high-rise buildings, and large industrial complexes. Bridges, dams, and offshore structures requiring deep anchorage. Buildings constructed on weak or waterlogged soils where shallow foundations would fail. Areas prone to soil erosion, liquefaction, or seismic activity, ensuring structural resilience. Deep foundations provide the necessary support for massive structures, ensuring their stability and longevity even in the most challenging environments. Engineers choose between different types of deep foundations, such as pile, pier, and caisson foundations, depending on the soil conditions and project requirements. Cross sections of different deep foundations. 1. Pile foundation. Description: a pile foundation consists of long, slender columns made of concrete, steel, or timber that are driven deep into the ground to transfer the building load to a stronger soil layer or bedrock. Piles are classified into two types: end-bearing piles, which rest on a hard stratum, and friction piles, which transfer the load through skin friction with the surrounding soil. Pile foundations are crucial for structures requiring deep support, particularly in weak or waterlogged soils. Applications: pile foundations are used in high-rise buildings, bridges, and offshore structures where deep soil stabilization is necessary. They are also applied in flood-prone areas and places with high water tables where shallow foundations are impractical. 2. Pier foundation. Description: A pier foundation consists of large cylindrical shafts excavated into the ground and filled with reinforced concrete. Unlike piles, piers are constructed by boring deep holes and pouring concrete into place. This foundation type is particularly useful for supporting heavy loads where deep excavation is possible. Applications. Pier foundations are commonly used for bridge supports, transmission towers, and heavy industrial structures where large loads need to be transferred to deep soil layers. 3. Caisson well foundation. Description. A caisson foundation is a watertight structure sunk into the ground, typically underwater, to create a stable foundation for marine and bridge structures. These foundations are constructed in sections, allowing them to be gradually lowered as excavation proceeds. Once at the desired depth, they are filled with concrete to create a solid base. Applications. Caisson foundations are used in offshore oil platforms, bridge piers, and ports where stable underwater support is required. Conclusion visual. Summary of key points and construction clips. That wraps up our discussion on foundations in civil engineering. Understanding the right foundation is key to constructing safe and durable structures. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Civil Engineering Edge. See you in the next video. And stay until next video, you all. Outro, music, subscribe button animation, and video suggestions.
Hello guys, watch this video and enjoy yourself. Please don't forget to share, like and comments on this channel and subscribe to watch the next video. Hello guys, watch this video and enjoy yourself. Please don't forget to share, like and comments on this channel and subscribe to watch the next video.